एवरीवन एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक. द टॉपिक इज फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गेनिज्म. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव यूनिट दैट इज स्टैमेन. ओके नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव यूनिट. ओके सो द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव यूनिट ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज गाइनेशियम. सो गाइनेशियम इज द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन ऑफ फ्लावर. ओके सो द यूनिट ऑफ गाइनेशियम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पिस्टिल और कार्पेल. सो वी कैन से दैट गाइनेशियम इज ऑल्सो नेम्ड एज पिस्टिल और कार्पेल. दीज थ्री नेम्स आर सेम. ओके गाइनेशियम मीन्स पिस्टिल, पिस्टिल मीन्स गाइनेशियम, गाइनेशियम मीन्स कार्पेल, कार्पेल मीन्स पिस्टिल. मीन्स यू कैन से दैट दीज आर द सिनोनिम्स टू इच अदर. ओके नेक्स्ट गाइनेशियम में कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए सिंगल पिस्टिल. इफ गाइनेशियम हैव वन पिस्टिल देन दैट इज द वन कार्पेल देन दैट इज नोन एज मोनोकार्पेलरी. ओके सो इफ द गाइनेशियम कंटेन ए सिंगल और वन पिस्टिल देन यू कैन से दैट दिस इज मोनोकार्पेलरी गाइनेशियम. ओके ओके लाइक दैट if gynoecium have more than one pistil then those gynoecium are called as multicarpillary gynoecium. okay so multicarpillary pistil may be two types, that is apocarpous and syncarpous. And you know that what is apocarpous, the when the carpels are free from each other and those are not fused together, then that type of carpel is known as apocarpous. Okay so in which plant we can see this type of carpels? Their rose plant, lotus, mycelia. In these plants we can see this type of carpel, apocarpous. Okay next is syncarpous. In syncarpous, syncarpous means when carpels are fused with each other or fused together, then that type of carpel is known as syncarpous. Okay so in which plant you can see? In papaver means papaya and hibiscus plant you can see the carpel of this type of carpel, syncarpous type. Okay remember, and you have to remember that carpel is also called as megasporophyll, is also called as megasporophyll. Okay so in class 11 also we have discussed, in class 10 also you know what are the parts of the carpel. Carpel or pistil have three parts. Okay so here you look, the first part is stigma and the second part is style and the third part is ovary. So these are the main three parts which are present in the carpel or pistil. Okay so the free end of the carpel which serves or its landing platform, here the pollen grains can come and interact with the stigma, okay, of carpel. Okay so these are the platforms are known as stigma, or these are the platforms which helps to interaction of pollen and pistil. Okay the pollen pistil interaction will be happen in this platform, that platform is known as stigma. Okay so next is the long and elongated narrow tubular structure in present in between stigma and ovary. So here stigma and ovary, these are long tubular structure which connect between stigma and ovary. That tubular structure is known as style. Okay good next is your the basal part or bulge part. Basal part, this is the basal part or bulge part present in the carpel, that is known as ovary. And inside the ovary there is a cavity or locule is present, that is known as ovule, that is known as ovule. So ovule is present inside the ovary, ovule is present inside the ovary. Okay good so in the ovary and cavity there is also the placenta is located, and in from the placenta the megasporangia arises, that is called ovule. In class 11 we already discussed about this. Suppose listen and also detect here. This is the ovary, yes or no? Okay, so inside the ovary there is a placenta, and from placenta these ovules are arisen. Okay, from placental wall these ovules are arise. Okay, you have to remember. Okay, now we will see what will be the structure of ovule. Okay, and also you have to remember, if a plant have one ovule, then some plants have more than one ovule. So in which plant the ovule is single, or in which plant the ovule is more than one? Okay, so the single ovule, the number of ovules in an ovary may be one in these plants, wheat, rice and mango plant, the number of ovules are one. That's why this is called monocot. Okay, and some plants have more than one ovule, those are called as multicarpellary or multi seeded plant also you can say, that is papaya, watermelon and orchids. Okay, now we will see the structure of ovule. See, this is the ovary wall. Suppose this is ovary. Okay, so this is ovarian wall. From ovarian wall there is placenta is there. From placenta there is a stalk like structure arises from the placenta and connect to the ovule. Understood or not? Again I am repeating, this is the ovary, and inside the ovarian wall there is placenta, and from placenta there is a stalk like structure which arises and connect with the ovule. Okay, I think you understood. Next, this long tube like structure connect the ovule with the ovarian with the placenta by a stalk like structure. This stalk like structure is known as funicle or funiculum or funicles. Okay, you have to remember. Okay, next is the main part, or the you can say the main basal part of the ovule. This is the ovule basal part is connected with this stalk like structure funicle. At this point, that point is known as hilum. Okay, good. Next comes to the basal part of ovule. In basal part of ovule, what we will see? The mass of, here you look, the basal part. Yes, the basal part, this is the basal part or the center part of the ovule, and that ovule is surrounded by or having the mass of parenchymatous cells. Those cells are called as neucellus. What is that? That is neucellus. Okay, and that neucellus is covered by the integument. These are the integuments. Okay, so how many integuments are present covered to this ovule? This ovule is covered by two integuments. That is outer integument. This is the outer integument, the orange color. Okay, and this is the inner integument, the blue color. The blue shaded portion is the inner integument. Okay. Next, you will see in the ovule there is embryo sac, and inside the embryo you will see the egg cell is here, and two synergids are there, two polar nuclei is here, and three antipodal cells are also here. Okay, so we'll see. And what is raphe? Raphe is the part, if the hilum is far, or you can say that if the funicle and ovule is connected at a some distance, or you can say the hilum is some distance from the placenta, then that ovule is connected with this funicle. At that point is known as raphe. Raphe means जिस ये थोड़ा अगर हाइलम ओव्यूल से थोड़ा दूर हो गया, तो जिस पॉइंट में ओव्यूल फ्यूनिकल के साथ जोड़ेगा उसी पॉइंट को क्या कहते हैं, राफी कहते हैं. ठीक है, ओके. नेक्स्ट वी विल सी ओके वी विल रीड वन बाय वन. Okay, and also here one thing, there is also a vascular tissue. These are the vascular tissue which are present in between funicle. So what is the function of this vascular tissue? They can transport food and nutrients to the ovule from the placenta through this vascular tissue, and the nutrients easily transported from placenta to the ovule. Okay, good. Next, we will see one by one. So, ovule is also known as integumented megasporangium. Means, ovule is covered by integument. And each ovule is attached to the placenta by means of a thin stalk. Already we have discussed that is called funicle or funiculus or funiculum. Next, the body of the ovule fuses with the funicle. टोटल बॉडी जो था वो क्या हुआ ना, फ्यूज किया फ्यूनिकल के साथ, और जिस रीजन में फ्यूनिकल के साथ ओव्यूल फ्यूज किया उसी रीजन को क्या कहते हैं, हाइलम. वी कैन से दैट रीजन इज कॉल्ड हाइलम. ओके, सो दस हाइलम रिप्रेजेंट्स द जंक्शन बिटवीन ओव्यूल एंड फ्यूनिकल. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट कम्स टू द न्यूसेलस पार्ट. द मेन रीजन ऑफ द ओव्यूल इज मेड ऑफ सम parenchymatous cell, already I have told you, with abundant reserve food material, that is called nucellus of the ovule. Okay, so nucellus is the main part of ovule. Remember one thing, and nucellus is covered by one or two coats covering that protects to the ovule. Okay, so those protective layer is known as integuments of ovule. Next, integuments cover the ovule except at the tip, okay, where a small opening that is called micropyle. Come to the figure and you see here there is not covered by integument, this part, okay. So there is a small space, you can say, or small hole is left by the integument. Those end is known as micropylar end. Those end is known as micropylar end, or micropyle you can say, this part. Okay, so remember one thing, in opposite to the micropyle, every times, or you remember always the side which is opposite to the micropylar end, that is chalazal end, that is chalazal end. Okay, so this part is the opposite to the micropyle, so this part is known as chalazal end of ovule. Okay, good. So next come to the in ovule raphe. What is raphe? In ovule of most plants, funicle is attached to the main body of ovule for some distance. जैसे हम बात कर रहे थे कि अगर funicle ovule को जोड़ रहा है और कुछ distance में रह जा रहा है, तो उसी को कहाँ, वो जो जिस distance पे
फ्यूनिकल ओव्यूल के साथ जोड़ जाएगा उसी पॉइंट को क्या कहेंगे, नराफी कहेंगे। ओके, सो इन ओव्यूल ऑफ मोस्ट प्लांट्स फ्यूनिकल इज अटैच टू द मेन बॉडी ऑफ ओव्यूल फॉर सम डिस्टेंस फॉर्म ए रिज लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, थोड़ा सा उठा हुआ होता है, दैट रिज लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज राफी। ओके रिमेंबर, एंड व्हाट इज वास्कुलर टिश्यू, वास्कुलर टिश्यू आर प्रेजेंट इन साइड द फ्यूनिकुलस व्हिच सप्लाई फूड मटेरियल फ्रॉम द प्लासेंटा टू द बॉडी ऑफ ओव्यूल। ओके नेक्स्ट कम्स टू द बेसल पार्ट, द बेसल पार्ट ऑफ द ओव्यूल व्हिच इज अपोजिट टू द माइक्रोप्लानेट इज कॉल्ड चलाजल एंड, ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड यू द चलाजल एंड, एंड ऑकेजनली इन सम सीड्स सच एज ब्लैक पीपर बीट एंड कास्टर रेमनेंट्स ऑफ न्यूसेलस आर परसिस्टेंट, वो रह जाता है, दिस रेसिडुअल और परसिस्टेंट न्यूसेलस इज द पेरिस्पम दैट विल फॉर्म द पेरिस्पम ऑफ ओव्यूल, एंड सम फिलामेंट्स आर अटैच्ड विद फ्यूनिकल एंड समटाइम्स विद द प्लासेंटा आर नोन एज ऑब्टुरेटर्स। ओके और व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ ऑब्टुरेटर्स, द फंक्शन ऑफ ऑब्टुरेटर्स इज टू गाइड द पासेज ऑफ अ पोलन ट्यूब ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन टुवर्ड्स द माइक्रोपाइल इन साइड द ओवरी। ओके तो यहाँ देखो ये, ओके दिस इज ऑब्यूल। ओके व्हेन पोलन ग्रेन जर्मिनेट, हियर इज द पोलन ग्रेन एंड एक्सटेंड्स इज पोलन ट्यूब एंड पोलन ट्यूब कम्स लाइक दिस। ओके एंड हियर इज द टू मेल गेमेट्स, तो ऑलवेज पोलन ट्यूब एंटर्स इन द ओव्यूल थ्रू द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड, थ्रू द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड, बट ऑब्टुरेटर ऑब्टुरेटर्स गाइडिंग द पोलन ट्यूब व्हेन द ओव्यूल इज रेडी टू फर्टिलाइज। ओके इफ ओव्यूल इज नॉट रेडी टू फर्टिलाइज देन ऑब्टुरेटर्स विल नॉट अलाउ द पोलन ट्यूब एंटर इन टू द ओव्यूल और एंटर इन टू द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड। ओके गुड, नेक्स्ट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर एम्ब्रियो सेक, एम्ब्रियो सेक इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एट द फीमेल गेमिटोफाइट। व्हाट इज एम्ब्रियो सेक, दिस इज द एम्ब्रियो सेक, यू रिमेंबर दिस इज द एम्ब्रियो सेक। ओके गुड, सो एम्ब्रियो सेक इज द फीमेल गेमेटोफाइट, हु इज फीमेल गेमेटोफाइट, एम्ब्रियो सेक इज द फीमेल गेमेटोफाइट। सो एन ऑब्यूल जनरली हैज ए सिंगल एम्ब्रियो सेक फॉर्म फ्रॉम ए मेगा स्पोर। ओके सो नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल सी व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ ऑब्यूल। ओके थैंक यू।